Good evening, buenas noches, estimados nuevos suscriptores. Elisa y Siddhartha, good evening, soy yo Siddhartha, su anfitrión. Y resumidamente, bienvenidos a un video más de Cine desde Perspectiva, canal de YouTube. Y lo dejamos así, and we leave it at that. Welcome to Cine desde Perspectiva channel. And, well, this video is going to focus once more on Star Wars The Last Jedi. Voy a enfocarme una vez más en Star Wars Los Últimos Jedi. Acabo de ver bastante material y acabo de dar con un discernimiento. I have found a new revelation about as to why Rian Johnson defined this story for Luke Skywalker the way it was intended in the movie. I hope you like what I'm going to say. I hope it's going to be brief. Before that, I have said that I was going to do a top 10 of the best movies of 2017. Also, I am going to do a top 10 about my favorite top 10 movies from 2017 and top 10 indie movies, plus a few of the worst movies of 2017, which there were some movies. Every year there's always good and bad movies. This is the balance of life, folks. And speaking of the balance of life, take this and consider this for further reference in this video. Sí, así que como les dije previamente, prometí un top 10 de mejores películas 2017, más va a haber un top 10 de mis favoritas del 2017. Y una de mis mejores películas, según yo, del 2017 en cuanto a cine independiente. Cine no tan comercial, ¿ok? So let's get to Star Wars The Last Jedi. Ok, so many of you got angry with Rian Johnson over as to why he defined Luke Skywalker the way he did. Why did he portray Luke Skywalker the way he did? Why did he took Luke into that awful nasty road? And why is Rey the hope for the galaxy? This image, want to use it to illustrate meantime. Well, you guys, there's a very fundamental reason for this. Indeed, there is a very fundamental reason as to why. The mosaic in this image, which you saw many times in the trailer, and this is a scene where Luke says about the raw force in someone, in Rey, he has seen it before, he wasn't blah 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 afraid then now he does. This mosaic you see here is gonna make a whole lot of sense if JJ and Chris Terrio play this movie well, if they write this movie well, and they see as much as I and many people have realized many things which subtly Rian Johnson made subtle use of, very subtle use of. And this has to do with this mosaic. And it has to do with Luke Skywalker. And I showed you in a previous video what this symbol, the mosaic, means and what it truly means. And only it has been seen in the Star Wars The Last Jedi visual dictionary, which has a lot of the things they did not use or apply well in the movie. It would have been more useful and more conscious and more acknowledgeable to understand the path Luke is on and why he's going about the Jedi this way. So, okay, now in Spanish, ahora en español. Pues bien, hay muchas visiones que mantenemos de Rian Johnson y en el diccionario visual de Star Wars, Los Últimos Jedi. Hay muchos simbolismos, muchas cosas que representan mejor la película y la historia que no usaron, pero el diccionario visual nos ilustra mejor. Como siempre es hasta el libro, un diccionario visual es lo que nos ilustra mejor la historia, lo que nos hace darle mejor sentido a lo que hicieron que la película misma. Incluso las novelas, no hablo gráficas, sino las novelas literarias, en relación, en base a las películas, como ha sido el de El Despertar de la Fuerza, cuentan mejor la historia en palabras que en cuestiones audiovisuales. So, graphic novels, no, but literature of Star Wars, like The Force Awakens, it has a little bit more of a descriptive, more of a close caption of the characters and what they were thinking, what we didn't hear them speak of, but we are described of, like close caption per se. But let's get now more into depth of things. There's some relations that which the likes I have seen lately about as to why it makes sense what happens to Luke in The Last Jedi, why it makes sense what we see from Luke in The Last Jedi. Many of you didn't understand. They have tried to look for answers. Surely this man really must have known this much as I'm telling you. I don't think they do this randomly. There must be some reason. They must know things so that we don't know certain things they do. There's certainly Rian Johnson works with a story group. In Lucas within Lucasfilms, he definitely doesn't do this all by himself, and there's a whole lot of references that they use. Now we're going into depth about it, okay? But just keep in mind that it is a very deeper truth to this, very fundamental truth. And it is by definition. It has to do with definition. Keep in mind that concept. I don't think this is going to be a brief video. But okay, let's go. So, in not few words, but good to go to great lengths and depths about this. How can I explain this to you? Well, as this re the realization that I have seen in depth about as to what happens to Luke and why it makes sense that Luke ends up in Act Two and he's in that attitude of piss off and very annoyed. Luke went through many turmoil, went through turmoil. He went through really nasty stuff, which we know has to do with the destruction of his Jedi Temple. But fundamentally, why he failed to train Ben Solo and why his Jedi Order failed, it's because there's a very fundamental flaw which Luke does, and not going to great extensive lengthiness, let's say, but Luke's big mistake. And this is something which it depends if you know how much you know about Star Wars lore and canon. If you've seen, for example, Star Wars, in the Star Wars canon, especially in the animated series, the CGI series, Star Wars, The Clone Wars, The Lost Missions, I think it's called. There are few episodes about the Force and Yoda exploring the Force and Anakin encountering very special beings which represent the Force. They explain it to you, but it's mostly you really must just stick with the film canon. There isn't much really in the film canon that explains it. It's very not clear in the film canon as to the very fundamental reason, the very fundamental flaw. But you kind of get it. You kind of get it. I've seen many videos and many information from Star Wars. and I'm going to do this for well as my video, and I don't know how much will I need to explain to you in time, but let's see. Well, you see, the Jedi Order in the prequels so far, going not too many, talk too much about the prequels really and get too much into the prequels. But basically, if you watch them again and you see them from a certain point of view, you get my reference. well, the Jedi Order fails. Actually, Luke does explain this a little bit in reference in a few sentences to Rey, which is that the Jedi Order failed. They feel so bad because they're the ones to blame for the rise of Darth Vader. Of course, he does the omission of not mentioning that Vader was his father. And going back to the prequels, basically seeing it from the point of view from that certain definition, the Jedi weren't successful, and it has to be logical so that episode 4 makes sense, so that there won't be no Jedi, but Obi-Wan, as far as we knew in The New Hope. But yeah, basically, without telling you too much, not boring you with too many words, basically what happens in the prequels, as far as Jedi concerned, the Jedi fail. The Jedi had, like, a very simple phrase explains about the Jedi. It's a cycle, see? The Jedi rose to become a civilized kind of people tuned in spiritually with a greater force, which is the Force, of course, and well, they became then said to become the guardians of the. There were peacekeepers in their time. They had they rose to power to protect the galaxy, and of course they had a glorious time. And as the cycle goes up, 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 and then they have to fall, and it did. Remember a certain line that Yoda says in episode 2, I think it is, that Jedi are becoming arrogant, and that is really something that you should have realized, that was a warning. Yoda had some moments of revelation. He went on his own missions of self-discovery and to go in great depths about the Force, the knowledge of the Force. That's why I recommend you making this parenthesis to watch some clips out there in YouTube as to Yoda. Look for Yoda in Clone Wars, special missions or something like that. It's on Netflix, I think it is. I think still it is. If not, look it up somewhere in Amazon, buy it. But yeah, I see these episodes because that was the most appealing to me, is to watch Yoda finds out about the Force. And it has to do redundantly with The Last Jedi. It all leads to The Last Jedi. The aftermath of the prequels and 4, 5, and 6 is The Last Jedi. Like I said, Luke pretty much explains it in a few sentences, that the Jedi were the ones responsible for the catastrophe that happens to the galaxy by allowing the rise of course we know, Palpatine and so forth, or Vader. But look, it pretty much, there's in the Clone Wars animated series, a phrase from a character, which says life is a cycle, and it is a cycle of life and destruction, good and evil, light and darkness, and too much from either of them is the destruction of life as you understand it. This is a dialogue of great, great, great knowledge. This is the most in-depth thing, which is very much like life is also. So, yeah, it is very, very, I don't know if you can grasp the truth of it, but it's raw knowledge. It is as it is. And let me go to another image. I think this guy really used this reference, but not in a precise fashion. Así que bueno, les estoy contando que básicamente en una serie, uso mucho la referencia en inglés de una serie animada que se llama Clone Wars, la guerra de los clones, pero no la película animada, sino la creo que es una temporada especial que hicieron que se llama Las Misiones Perdidas o algo así, o de Las Misiones Especiales, algo así. Búscala en YouTube. Hago la referencia a esta parte del canon que existe, es canon, es parte de la saga. Hay un episodio, unos cuantos episodios en los cuales Yoda profundiza más en la se sumerge a las profundidades del conocimiento sobre la fuerza, conoce a algunos seres muy especiales que le enseñan sobre la verdad y la realidad de la fuerza. Y Anakin, por otro lado, también hay unos episodios de esta misma serie, búsquenla, se las recomiendo ampliamente. Y si algunos ya la han visto, saben que voy a ir a lo que voy a ir cuando voy a referirme a lo que sucede en los últimos Jedi. Tiene mucho sentido y redundancia, valga la redundancia que tiene. Y es que, pues, Anakin va a dar en una misión con unos seres, dos seres muy especiales, que son el equilibrio de la fuerza, los que representan o encarnan el equilibrio de la fuerza. El papá es un extremo, que es creo que la luz, y la hija es la oscuridad, y hablan mucho constantemente en el lore, en el canon de Star Wars, del equilibrio. Ahora vamos a entrar a ciertas cosas. Inclusive en el diccionario visual de Star Wars, Los Últimos Jedi, hay cosas, símbolos, simbolismos que emplearon basados en el shintoísmo, corríjame si me equivoco, en filosofía oriental, sí, sobre símbolos de seres, sobre todo el primer Jedi, que existió, el primer Jedi que hubo, digamos, el Buda de Star Wars, digamos, que fundamentalmente fue el que dio con la fuerza, quien profundizó, el primero que profundizó fue el Buda de Star Wars, digamos. Entonces, pues he allí el meollo del asunto. ¿Por qué tiene que asociación con Los Últimos Jedi y con lo que es la tragedia que pasa en gran medida en Los Últimos Jedi? La falla de nuestro amado Luke, nuestro querido Luke, pues fundamentalmente su falla es que Luke, después del regreso del Jedi, él ve que es su oportunidad de, como suponíamos, de él asumir, tomar las riendas de la Orden Jedi. Pues Yoda le dice que una vez que el Yoda fallezca, Luke va a ser el último Jedi. Entonces, desde ahí ya sabíamos la cuestión del título, que de hecho ya era muy obvio que iba a ser el último Jedi, que de hecho es el título de, más concretamente, del episodio 8. Pero la falla, aquí vamos a esto. La cuestión de por qué Luke acaba como acaba en el episodio 8 es porque hay una falla fundamental, y que es de hecho donde me doy cuenta que Rian Johnson sí llevó a cabo una consistencia de los personajes y de Luke en específico. Es en que si Luke, bueno, ya suponemos y sabemos que llevó a cabo su orden Jedi, se abocó a ser Jedi, y parecía muy bien, pero la realidad es, para la realidad de la galaxia de Star Wars, no lo fue. ¿Por qué? Porque, vaya, miren, la falla de esto es que Luke, al abocarse solamente a predicar y a enseñar y abocarse a la luz, pues definitivamente lo llevó a enseñar la Orden Jedi, la luz y eso, pero al hacer eso descuidó proteger la galaxia. Eso conllevó, implicó que la oscuridad surgiera, resurgiera, que es que por otro lado, el Imperio Galáctico se fue, cuales cucarachas se fueron a esconder a algún rincón oscuro de la galaxia, que fuera seguro, que fue las regiones desconocidas de la galaxia, y luego resurgieron, regresando de esa región con más poder y con otro ser igual, o según dice Andy Serkis en entrevistas, más maligno y más poderoso que el mismísimo emperador y Darth Vader juntos. ¿Ustedes creen? ¿Qué opinan? Opinen abajo. Pero si Luke, pues, por omisión, por falla de omisión, descuidó la galaxia al abocarse a lo que estaba haciendo, a solamente su orden y la falla de su orden estuvo en una cosa muy sencilla. Luke se abocó solamente a enfocarse en la luz. Y sí fue una falla. Y es algo que de hecho en los últimos Jedi, sin desviarme de la película tanto, como pueden ver en los libros que tienen esta imagen, que aquí no se ve, y son los que se roba Rey en la película, ¿cierto? Como bien entienden, y lo dice Yoda, la chica lleva todo lo que necesita. No lo dicen en un sentido figurado de que Rey posea ya un conocimiento, o ya nazca con un conocimiento y lo esté desarrollando, sino que lleva los libros. Y sí hay una escena al final donde, según cuentan, tal vez eso se nos escapó a la vista, están ya a bordo del Halcón Milenario y ahí está. Esta es una de las cosas que deben de seguro estar en este libro, y es este símbolo y esta leyenda que estaba de por sí impresa en el mosaico dentro del árbol de la fuerza, y es esta, del primer Jedi que existió en la historia de la galaxia. Y como pueden ver, bueno, se basa en el hinduismo y habla del yin, el yang, que es donde toman, de hecho, el fundamento mucho para el canon de Star Wars, del shintoísmo, de la filosofía oriental, de cosas metafísicas y muy profundas. Y esta es una clara referencia, clara, que no creo que muy, creo que se les escapó cómo explicarlo en la trama de Star Wars, The Last Jedi. I am explaining in Spanish. Basically, pretty much what I told you in English, as to that fundamentally, but anyways, I'm going to try to do this in English. What you see here is something that I already explained in a previous video, but now it makes a whole different sense now that I know certain things, which I didn't realize as much. You see, Luke, after the Return of the Jedi, after he destroyed the Empire, apparently, Luke's big flaw was that he, by becoming the advocate of the light, he forgot to keep a close eye on the dark side. The dark side users, the Empire, because the Empire, because of Luke's omission, and his carelessness and his focus just on the light, the darkness, well, they regrouped themselves, went to the foreign regions of the galaxy, which is an unknown part of the galaxy, or of the universe for that matter, of the cosmos, and they regrouped themselves, met with some other new peculiar characters, especially one by the called, sorry, especially one that whom goes by the name of Snoke. And Snoke, supposedly, according to Andy Serkis, according to his own words, Snoke is more powerful than the Empire, the Emperor, and Vader together. Can you believe that? And so he came back, reagrouped the, reordered the new order, and well, they became more powerful. They became more nasty, more powerful, and more reorganized. And that is Luke's flaw. There is a very simple phrase used in by one of the characters in the Star Wars canon, whom appears in, like I said before, Star Wars, the Clone Wars, the Lost Missions, and it goes like, too many light or too many darkness leads to, well, leads to destruction of life as one understands it. You get the idea? This symbol over here, which got me back to The Last Jedi, pretty much illustrates that phrase. Too many darkness, too many light is destruction of life as one understands it. Why is this phrase so meaningful, so redundantly powerful, coming back to The Last Jedi? It's coming back and forth as an echo from a distant part of the lore of the galaxy of Star Wars, redundantly here. And this is even likely to be the future for Star Wars and the redefinition for the Jedi. Because Luke's flaw was fundamentally that he focused only upon light and understanding and practicing and teaching the Jedi wisdom as only light should prevail. And it is a fatal and flaw, a very flaw, big flaw from Luke. To just mirror and just be just a rewind of the old Jedi Order, which was one taught and practiced by the old Jedi Order from the prequel trilogy era by Anakin, Yoda, well, not Yoda really, but the other Jedi. Say, for example, Mace Windu. And that is a fundamental flaw. No balance in the Force, no balance in the galaxy is destruction of life as one understands it or knows it. So this from certain perspective, certain point of view, like Obi-Wan says to Luke at one point in The New Hope, is pretty much a fact. So how does this have to do with Luke being such a grouch, such a grinch in The Last Jedi? Well, Luke is frustrated because he failed to understand the and grasp the bigger truth, the bigger picture truth about the cosmos, about the cosmovision, about which he tries to understand, and that is that then he must have felt really awful, really shitty that he couldn't grasp the full knowledge of the Force and full understanding as it should have been, as he realized he should have taught it fully as it should be, teaching Jedi to be beings that embrace both light and darkness rather than just one side or the other. It is also the flaw of the Sith who have only embraced darkness. Now I come to realize why Kylo Ren makes so much sense, his purpose makes so much sense, and why you really get what he says when let the past go, kill it, or something like that. So his intention is to let go of the past, and if you must kill it, that is true. And this is something that really is a tendency that we don't know how it's gonna go. How are they going to redefine this concept of Jedi? It seems that Kylo Ren doesn't want not even the word Jedi in the dictionary anymore, but something else, we don't know what. It is yet to be defined in episode 9, but so far, according to the visual dictionary and this illustration, it may mean a new kind of, maybe not Jedi, or maybe yes Jedi, but embracing both light and darkness. It may mean, this might mean for episode 9 for Rey to become the new Jedi Order, which teaches younglings and Padawans, or maybe not even Padawans, or some other kind of definitions and hierarchies, you know, or status or whatever. A new kind of understanding of the Force, embracing life as it is, darkness and light. And it is also, by the way, realizing what Snoke tried to understand, make Kylo and Rey understand, that darkness rises and light to meet it. This is a very constant thing. It has to do even with killing the past, erasing the past, and embracing the future instead. Isn't this very curious, a little conjunction, don't you think? Trying to embark onto something else. Perhaps race endeavors will have to do with creating a new kind of understanding. Maybe she will read the books, find the symbol, understand that fundamentally the balance is the greater truth and the deepest truth of the Force. Then she will have to teach it as it is. And this is where it will be interesting to see how J.J. Abrams and Chris Terry will develop this very fundamental fact about how this Force concept is defined in Star Wars. And it is a constant and a consistency of, as far as Jedi story and history it is. So there you go. This is why Luke is pissed off. He's pissed off. Of course, he destroyed someone. His nephew destroyed his temple. He took some of his students, probably these famous Knights of Ren people. And even worst of all, Luke is pissed off and upset because he had trouble understanding that his biggest flaw is he should have taught his students to embrace the balance of the Force, which is the Force. Again, redundantly, yes. Light and dark. Light and darkness. Just like Snoke pretty much well says it so. Darkness rises and light to meet it. And opposite way, like light arises and darkness to meet it. It is a balance, it is a cycle of life. So this is fundamentally why Luke's big flaw was his own doing. That was Luke's undoing. His biggest flaw was to grasp this greater truth. And oh boy, poor Luke. He decides, he gives up. He wasn't a good teacher. And she just wants to try to live alone, all alone in Octu. But ultimately, there has to be some. He did come to his senses at the very end and realized, well, at least, why not become a legend? Do something for the galaxy somehow with what he knows and he can do as a Jedi, which was doing his Force projection, Force astral projection thing, and doing what he did so that at least he did what he did at the end. So there you have it. This is the much deeper understanding of what why Luke is the way, why it makes sense that they defined this story for Luke this way. Luke's ultimate flaw also has to do, and I almost forgot, is failure. This is a consistency of issue in, along the movie and throughout the movie, I mean, and that is that Luke fails to grasp greater truths and depths of wisdom. And one of them is learning from failure, and the other to grasp fully the bigger truth. It's much bigger than that. Or maybe he did ultimately, but only till the end, because in the first lesson that he gives to Rey, it is to see things as they are, and it is light and darkness. Ahora en español, porque me explayé muy bien en inglés. Pero miren, básicamente lo que digo es que ya vamos 36 minutos. Ok, no me voy a tardar mucho. Verán, la falla fundamental de Luke es entender la verdad más grande y más profunda y el hecho más profundo que existe, bueno, menos. Y eso es también algo que pasa en la vida real, es el balance, el ciclo de la vida, el balance que existe en la vida, el yin, el yang, el bien, el mal, la destrucción, la vida, etc. Básicamente en esos conceptos, bajo esa definición y esta ilustración que aparece no claramente y no bien empleada en Los Últimos Jedi. En el mosaico que está dentro del árbol Jedi, en una de las escenas en las que tiene diálogo Luke y Rey, este lo ilustra el primer Jedi, como lo explica el diccionario visual de Star Wars, Los Últimos Jedi, explica muy bien que este fue el primer Jedi y fue, digamos, como dijo, valga la redundancia, el Buda de Star Wars, porque es el primer Jedi, el primer ser o criatura o alguien que por lo que parece es un alien que pues profundizó en la fuerza y vio que había luz y oscuridad. Y esto es algo que de hecho decía en inglés, Luke le enseña a Rey y el Rey aprende a ver la luz y la oscuridad, que ese es el equilibrio de la vida. Luke parece ser que falló en comprender esto, tanto así que cuando fundó su primera orden, su orden Jedi, bajo su concepto de la fuerza, fue fallido. Porque, pues, como quizá ya les expliqué, valga la redundancia, al enfocarse en la luz solamente y encender la luz, pues esa fue la falla. No es el balance. Y debió haber enseñado a sus alumnos a apreciar la vida por lo que es el balance entre la luz y la oscuridad. Y no solamente la luz. El inhibir la oscuridad y reprimir la oscuridad es negar la vida misma y eso resulta en que surja la oscuridad. Y he ahí el meollo del asunto. Es como lo dice elocuentemente Snoke y tiene mucho sentido lo que dice cuando dice la oscuridad surge y la luz va a su encuentro. Parece que se traduce así. Y es al revés también. La oscuridad, la luz surge y ay, disculpen, y pues oscuridad se encuentra, ¿no? Esto es básicamente lo que yo digo y es la falla de Luke. Destruye, claro, Ben Solo destruyó su templo, pero si Luke hubiera enseñado a aceptar este hecho y enseñarlo a sus alumnos, pues tomen en cuenta que Luke hubiera reaccionado muy diferente en esas escenas que nos mostraron donde enfrenta a su sobrino. No hubiera enfrentado a su sobrino. El más grande problema de Luke consistentemente en su vida ha sido el fracaso, y eso sale en el episodio 5. Nuevamente en el 8, Yoda, el mismo que le enseñó esta lección sobre el fracaso, nuevamente se lo muestra, le muestra dónde está su falla. al fracaso, y eso es algo, una lección de la película. Filosóficamente está bien hecha esta película, entonces. Entonces, si fuera cierto que es como suponíamos, y Luke, no, pero Luke es un Jedi bueno, entonces de hecho estamos mal suponiendo así, que como suponíamos y creíamos que debe ser con Luke, por definición, porque de hecho los Jedi, como podemos ver, el primer Jedi, pues aceptó este concepto del equilibrio en la fuerza, y Luke solamente se enfocó en un aspecto de este balance, y al hacer nada más de un lado, nada, y reprimiendo la oscuridad, pues resultó en que la oscuridad surge. Fue al revés desde esa perspectiva, porque Luke, al surgir con la luz y enseñarla, pues la oscuridad pues surge por otro lado también y va a su encuentro, ¿no? ¿Y qué, cómo fue? Pues Kylo Ren se manifestó en Kylo Ren, en Ben Solo, y él se convirtió en esa otra mitad innegable e ineludible. Así que Luke además repitió los mismos patrones que la vieja Orden Jedi de los tiempos de Yoda, de Mace Windu y todos ellos. Uy, ya se me está acabando la batería. Pero bueno, esto es lo que yo les quería explicar. Esta es la razón fundamental por la cual está así definido a Luke Skywalker, su carácter, su personalidad, sus acciones, etcétera, su psicología en Star Wars, Los Últimos Jedi. No sé si hay una verdad más profunda que esa, pero con información y muchas cosas que he averiguado, muchas cosas, muchas reflexiones que he visto, se las he compartido. So this is pretty much the in-depthness about as to why Luke Skywalker is the way he is, why he turned out to be the Grinch Jedi, which he ends up being. We have to understand, poor fellow. He just is very frustrated. He couldn't grasp the greater truth about this. So definitely he could never grasp the fullness of this. If he had been a great Jedi, he would have taught darkness light, and so Ben Solo wouldn't have turned into darkness, because dark side manifested through Kylo Ren, and so darkness arose through Kylo Ren. Let's see what turns up in 9. Así que vamos a ver qué pasa en el 9, cómo redefinen este concepto de la fuerza y cómo van a redefinir los Jedi. See you. This is all for today. Very soon, I think tomorrow, likely we'll be doing a top, finally uploading the top 10 for best of 2017 and so forth in the upcoming days. I hope you like them, and I'll see you next time. Así que próximamente, esperen dentro de los próximos días los top sobre lo de 2017, lo mejor, lo peor, y mis 10 favoritas. So, si ustedes tienen 10 favoritas, escríbanlas en. Bueno, no aquí comente sobre lo que acabo de hablar de Star Wars, qué opine sobre lo que dije. Y tengan en mente esto. ¿Yes? Ja, 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 ja. Dark side of the force. Darkness arises. And light to meet it. Trying to imitate the emperor. Estoy imitando al emperador. So, beware. So, see you next time, guys. Hasta la próxima. Y hasta luego. 44 minutes. Okay. Well, you guys, see you. Have a great weekend. Tengan un excelente fin de semana.
Yeah.